In this lecture, we will learn collector feedback biasing. In case of emitter biasing, we introduce emitter resistance, and because of it, the stability of the operating point increases. The stability of the operating point can also be improved by the introduction of feedback from collector to base, and this is what we are doing in collector feedback biasing. We are introducing the feedback from collector to base, and first we will calculate the current IC and the voltage VCE. They are the coordinates of the operating point, and after this we will discuss advantages and disadvantages of collector feedback biasing. IB is the current in this branch, IC is the current in this branch, and I want to calculate the current in this branch. Let's say the current is I. I will use Kirchhoff's current law at this node to calculate the current I. According to Kirchhoff's current law, the sum of entering currents is equal to the sum of leaving currents. You can see IC is the leaving current, IB is also the leaving current, and I is the entering current. So simply, current I is equal to IC, the collector current, plus IB, the base current. And now I will calculate the base current by applying the Kirchhoff's voltage law in the input loop. We have VCC minus IC plus IB multiplied with resistance RC. Drop across this resistance is equal to I multiplied with RC, and I is equal to IC plus IB. So we have IC plus IB multiplied with RC minus IB multiplied with resistance RB. Drop across this resistance minus VBE equal to zero. So this is the equation, and we will try to calculate the current IB using this equation. We already know the collector current IC is equal to beta times IB. So we can write collector current IC equal to beta times IB. I will take IB common from this and this term. So let's see what we have. VCC minus inside the bracket beta plus 1 times RC plus RB multiplied with IB minus VBE equal to 0. So current IB is equal to VCC minus VBE divided by beta plus 1 RC plus RB. So this is the expression of base current IB, and now we will find out the collector current. The collector current IC is simply beta times IB, beta times IB. So we have beta inside the bracket VCC minus VBE divided by beta plus 1 RC plus RB. So this is the expression for the collector current, and in this way we have Y coordinate of the operating point. The next thing is the calculation of the voltage VCE, and for that we will apply KVL in the output loop. So let's apply KVL in the output loop. We will start from VCC. VCC minus I multiplied by RC minus VCE equal to 0. Capital I is equal to IC plus IB, collector current plus base current. So we have VCC minus IC plus IB multiplied with RC minus VCE equal to 0. And from this equation we can easily calculate the voltage VCE. It is equal to VCC minus IC plus IB multiplied with RC. We have already evaluated the expression for IC, you can see here, and by putting all the values we can calculate current IC. And once we have current IC, we will put it here in this expression, and finally we can have VCE. So this is the final expression for the voltage VCE, and now we will move to the advantages and disadvantages of collector feedback configuration. First we will talk about the advantages. The collector feedback configuration stabilizes the operating point, against the variation of temperature, against the variation of temperature. This is the first advantage, and it also stabilizes the operating point against the variation of biasing voltage, VCC. The third advantage is the stabilization of operating point against the variation of beta value. You can easily prove the current IC is independent of beta. It is equal to beta times VCC minus VBE divided by RB plus inside the bracket beta plus 1 RC. Beta plus 1 is nearly equal to beta, so we have beta here. And if beta times RC is greater than RB, we can neglect RB, so we are left with RC multiplied with beta in the denominator, and the beta in numerator will cancel out with beta in denominator, and you can see the expression is independent of beta value. So this is the third advantage of collector feedback configuration. Now we will talk about the disadvantages. You can see in the last advantage, we have to follow this condition. Beta times RC must be greater than RB. And most of the times, we do not have the exact idea of beta value. So to satisfy this condition, we have to make RC very large, or we can make resistance RB very low. Now if we make RC very large, the high value of biasing voltage VCC is required. And because of this, cost will increase. And also the precautions will increase. If we make RB very low, then reverse bias of collector base junction will reduce. So this is the disadvantage of the collector feedback biasing. I hope this is clear to you. So this is all you should know about the collector feedback biasing. I will end this lecture here. See you in the next one.